first off is the Schneider Brauhaus, which has been here since 1872, I think it was, as a brewery. And Georg Schneider I Schneider was granted the first brewery of wheat beer labeled by King Ludwig to make it for Germany. I am going to have the pork baked in beer, which is the Schneider's Aventus and Brauhaus. And Steve is going to have the Schweinhaxe, the pork knuckle. And both these are classic pork products which we cook here. And to go with it, we're going to have some pretzel. I'm going to have pretzel because Steve hates pretzel. We are our first stop, Munich, in the Schneider Brauhaus.
So we've had our first stop and a walk around. Now we're heading to tick off the big tourist trap, well, tourist place, the Hofbrauhaus, for a big beer.
So we're in the Hofbrauhaus, very, very noisy. We've got our ginormous beers, very heavy. This place was given the first brewing order in Germany and the world in 1516. It's the first brewing, first food law, actually, ever. And they have been bringing their dark beer traditionally. So we went for the Dunkel, the dark beer. They have the Weiss beer. We were told, don't eat here, but drink here instead. It's insane, I can't even hear myself. Turn it all off. So we're here in the Franziskaner pub, brewery, opposite the Opera House. I think with Opernhaus, the cheese, paprika spice dip, which is very, very popular in the south of Germany. We get that. And this is our sort of, I believe it's our third stop of the day. I'm feeling the beer now. And then we're gonna go get probably some sausage or something.
So we're ending our night in the Nürnberger Bratwurst Glocke. We have our plate of sausages here. We've gone for the mixed platter and we're serving it with some, again, local beer as usual. Most of these places are also breweries. They have their own beer. How are you feeling, Steve?
Great.
How are you actually feeling?
Drunk.
Me too. We're back in Schneider. To try the traditional Weisswurst, which is the white sausage. It's veal and pork back bacon. You've got spices, I found a list. You've got parsley, lemon, mace, onions, ginger, and cardamom. And they stuff it into the pork casing and they boil it, but not so much that you colour it. So you don't eat the casing, you kind of open the casing and you have to sort of shimmy it out. And you dip it in sweet mustard and you serve it with pretzels. And apparently, even though we've already been here by accident, this is actually the best place to get it. So we're going to have more food at Schneider. And it's 11 o'clock in the morning, or 11:15. You can only get the Weisswurst before 12. As soon as the bell chimes, there's no more sausages, so we're having our beer before 12 o'clock, so close. Isartor guest house, and we ordered Käse Spätzle, which is this sort of a local type of mac and cheese style dish. You've got a pasta noodle, which they'll grate into boiling water and it rises up to the top. You load it up with bacon, herbs, garlic, and different cheeses. I think it's three cheeses. Bake it in the oven, you cover it with caramelized onion, you serve it with salad. Just try it. It's freaking amazing. So we're here in Fussen at the base of the hill with Neil Schwanstein in. We're missing lunch, we're in Agida. I think it's the eagle, right? We're starting with the soup. I can't remember how to pronounce the name, but it's got potato dumplings strips inside it, salted beef, carrots all resting in like a bouillon broth. This is our kind of a party starter before we get our sausages and more beer.
And it wouldn't be Germany without the currywurst, my favourite dish. Sausage, curry sauce, curry ketchup, curry powder and chips.
So Steve and I are here in Freiburg, and it's been a very wet day in the Black Forest. We've seen a couple of castles, we've seen vineyards, and I'm drinking currently a glass of Pinot Noir Spätburgunder, red wine from the Baden-Baden region. And we've come to this lovely little place, I can't remember the name, I'll write it on screen now. And we're talking to some Schweinhaxe, which is my first one of the trip. And after this, I'm going to have myself the famous, what's the name of the cake?
Black Forest cake.
Exactly right. And then we're going to drink some more wine and escape the rain. So yeah, cheers. So we're nearing the end of our German part of the trip. So I'm going to go for an old, kind of cheap and easy classic, the Flammkuchen, which is essentially Germany's answer to a pizza. I've got one called Creme Fraiche and Speck and cheese on. And I'm pairing it, because we're in the village of Meersburg, with a local white wine made with the Müller-Thurgau grape. White wine pizza, but Weißwein und Flammkuchen.
So it's our last night in Germany. First part of this trip, and we are finishing with another classic speciality, Leberkäse, which translates as liver cheese. This is a kind of a meatloaf, a baked loaf of pork and beef, I believe. And they serve with a couple of fried eggs and some chives and potatoes, and it's kind of like a cooked loaf of meat. It's about as German as you can get. And of course, a dark bitter. So from Germany, auf Wiedersehen.